COVID-19. Which groups are still dying in the U.S.? The current vaccination campaign against COVID-19 in the U.S. has greatly decreased the death rate across all states. Data shows that the deaths declined by 90% since it peaked in January. However, reports also show that hundreds of patients still die every day. In late May, almost 2,500 weekly deaths were associated with COVID-19. So, why COVID-related deaths remain that high? According to the New York Times, the population group now taking a good chunk in the death pie is young adults. If examined across all age groups, the death rate has truly declined, but per age group, those aged over 60 with comorbidities are no longer the biggest participant of that pie. "I'm not seeing that as much anymore," said Dr. Kritika Kopali, infectious disease expert, Medical University of South Carolina. One explanation would be the over 80% of adults aged 65 and older now partially vaccinated. That percentage is higher than 50% of adults aged 25 to 64 who got their first dose. Dr. Kopali suggested that the consistently high death rate is mainly driven by people who haven't received at least one dose. The expert described two main groups in this population: people who chose not to be vaccinated and people who can't get their doses. The first group is likely powered by misinformation and politicization of the vaccine. These elements have convinced them not to take the vaccine. This thus not only risks others from COVID-19, but also brings no help in controlling community transmission. The second group is likely powered by existing troubles in vaccination. Many individuals don't know where to get vaccines, don't know the shots are free, and don't have much free time to get away from work for several days. Within both groups, younger people are the wild card because many believe they won't suffer from life-changing consequences due to COVID. Healthcare workers and scientists have determined that any human is prone to severe symptoms. In a report by the US CDC, hospitalization among adolescents aged 12 to 17 increased between March and April, after declining in January and February. The rate peaked at 2.1 per 100,000 teens in early January, declined to 0.6 in the middle of March, and rose again to 1.3 in April. Almost one-third of adolescent patients were admitted to the ICU, and 5% had to receive invasive mechanical ventilation. As of June 3, 2021, over 5.9 million teens have received one dose of a COVID-19 vaccine.